English Ma'ar. And perhaps it's more personal for Rabbi Hertz in the shul business. And he says it's not. Is there anything that we could find in the Rebbe mentioned more direct for parents and students who are graduating, spending 4 years, a milestone in life? Is there anything, maybe Hashgacha Pratis that the Rebbe mentioned specifically this time of the year? So maybe my Hashgacha Pratis was that there is a Rishima that the Rebbe specifically spoke this time of the year, 74 years ago, Achrin, Isru Chag Shavuos. Isru Chag Shavuos, the Rebbe was sitting at a new event, the Friedrich Rebbe instituted that people should do Mishnayos Balpeh, and it looks like that the Rebbe gave a sicha for the first opening of this Mishnayos Balpeh session. And the Rebbe opens the event. It's one of the Rishimis, and the Rebbe says a fascinating sicha about the importance of learning Mishnayos Baal Peh. And the Rebbe speaks about Kriya Shema. And the importance of Kriya Shema, in short, is the punchline of life. And how a person survives in life in Yiddishkeit, Begashmias, Uberuchnias. And the Rebbe says the first mitzvah that a person is mechuyev, perhaps, is Kabbalas Oil Malchus Shemayim. And that's why, according to most of the Rishonim, a bar mitzvah boy, and perhaps a bar mitzvah, bas mitzvah, is Kriya Shema, Me'emosa Kerem Shema Ba'arvin, is the first mitzvah mentioned in Mishnayis, because that's the first mitzvah. Kabbalas Oil Malchus Shemayim is accepting upon yourself your yoke of heaven. Kabbalah soil, it's the first thing you know. You go to yeshiva, you go to school. Kabbalah soil, they'll drill that into your head. Kabbalah soil. So what does the Mishnah say? Twice a day, ba'erev, ba'layla, u'bayoyim, night and day, Kabbalah soil, what's this all about? Says the Rebbe, let's put aside the nigla perspective, the halachic perspective of Kabbalah soil. Everybody talks about this. Let's talk about the Avodas Hashem of Kabbalah Oil. And there's two outlooks, Kabbalah Oil in Avodas Hashem. There is the Yoyin, there is the Laila. You have to say Shema by Yoyin, you have to say Shema by Laila. Yoyin symbolizes day. All is going well. All is going well, Begashmias. All is going well, Beruchnius. All is going well, Begashmius means Parnas is fine, your kids are healthy, Shidduchim is going well, life is going good. Sure, Kabbalah soil. You know what you need Kabbalah soil? Sometimes you get arrogant. Sometimes you don't realize it's Hashem. Sometimes it gets to your head. Kabbalah soil. That's where you need Kabbalah soil. Where is it in Avodas Hashem, the Yoyin? Sometimes life is easy. Sometimes the 100 on the test comes in easy. You're a smart person. You're easy. Life, you have easy, good friends. You have a good teacher. To study, the marks come in easy for you. Kabbalah soil. Your friend, it doesn't come in that easy. You have to thank Hashem for that. And then there is Choshech. And then there is Laila, says the Rebbe. You need Kabbalah soil for that too. What's the Choshech and what's the Laila? Nebach. In the Gashmisa means, it doesn't go that well. Sometimes, Parnosa get nish good, Rachman Litzlan. Gesund get nish good, Rachman Litzlan. And you don't have to spell it out. People Nebach suffer Begashmias. Beruchnias. People have nisyonis, Rachman al-Tzlan. Everybody has nisyonis. The Yetzirah, the Eibishter sends the Yetzirah for a reason, for a test. But Kabbalah soil, it's all there to test the person to make him better. And this is the first mitzvah. The first mitzvah and the Kabbalah soil is the first thing that we have to put us, the first one. Sigh for the boy, for the bas mitzvah, and sigh for the girl. Cipher the bar mitzvah, man, Marsa Karnish my barvin. And one of the most beautiful things we find, I found this once as a joke, and I said the story 100 times, because I think it's a beautiful thing. When a person wakes up in the morning, many people have this habit that can't survive without their coffee in the morning. I read this once, and I keep on repeating it, and people laugh at it, but it's a tremendous story. You wake up in the morning, you take a cup of coffee, take a cup. What happens in the cup? You pour in a little coffee. Coffee is bitter. To balance it out, 5 star ayin abyssal sugar, sweet. Then you want, coffee, bitter or sweet. You put in hot water, it's hot. Hot is, you can't drink hot. 5 star ayin abyssal milk, cold. So you got bitter, sweet, cold, hot, and what's the first thing you say? Shahako mir bedvarei. Whatever Hashem sends to you, that day, whatever happens that day, bitter or sweet, cold, hot. So, Svissen sein, Shahakom mir bedvarei. That is the goal in life. That is your mission in life. The first thing, says the Rebbe, Kabbalah soil malchus shemayim. Kabbalah soil malchus shemayim. Yoin, Laila. Zomishayin kan Laila. And you have to know that the Laila is there. So laharim nes, a nest in the Sayin is to uplift you. The Lashon laharim nes, to lift you to a higher garden. Now, in a couple of days we're going to celebrate Shavuos. There's many, many reasons why we eat milchiks. You're going to hear because milchiks, Torah is compared to milchiks. You're going to have, Rabbi Hertz will give you many drushes why Torah is compared to milchiks. But there was a very famous pasuk. Ner mitzvah v'teira er. Ner mitzvah v'teira er means the Torah. Ner is like a mitzvah, is like a ner, like a candle, and Torah is like a flame. And the question is, why specifically a candle and a flame? We keep on hearing so many comparisons. We hear to fruits, to water. What's the comparison here to a flame and a candle? So this is the message I would like to leave. I want to talk to myself. I want to talk to my daughter. I'd like to share with all my chaverim and to everybody. Rabbi, a candle has this unique thing. A flame has this unique thing. A fire lights and burns. You open a window, Rahman al-Aflan, it could extinguish the fire. The window is a blessed avint from Kfira. Outside, there is kfira outside. There's kfira, there's internet shtusim. And I'm talking, this is a person that lives off the internet. But there's a lot of shtuyot outside. There's a lot of nonsense outside. There's a lot of things that you gotta make sure you gotta arizvai from outside. But at the same time, ner mitzvah, look around you. Fire also has a tremendous thing. If put together twigs. If you vifarai in a couple of more holes, more wood, fire makes a forest fire. Fire could consume a tremendous fire, a forest. How? The more and more wood you put in there, you could consume a shtuk, a whole air, a whole city. It depends what you do with it. It depends who you surround yourself with it, around with. So watch what you do. If it's a ner mitzvah, if the surrounding is, if you open the window, and Rahman al-Atlan, it's a window of kfira, if the surrounding is shtuyat, nonsense, a wind of shtuyat, it's going to extinguish the candle, Rahman al-Atlan. If the surrounding around you, Baruch Hashem, the people you surround yourself here, our rabbanim, our teachers, our chassidish people, Ibe again to Yiddishkeit, to Chassidishkeit, to the Rebbe, to the right thing, and Baruch Hashem, you're committed to go to better and greater places, Ashreichem. And make sure you keep on growing and let the fire of Torah grow.
I'm Huh? No, you make me the coffee. No, I charge you. Oh.